There's a number of critical challenges that we're facing. Environmental problems, overcrowding in the cities, congestion, energy. We have to secure our energy future. All of these challenges are pretty much in the field of civil and environmental engineering.
The challenges of our time that have huge scales and they require a very new approach in thinking across disciplines.
If you want to make better cities, if you want to make healthier environments for cities, you need science, you need engineering, you need design, and so the problems don't really respect traditional boundaries.
In the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering, we are developing a new educational program, which we call OneEng.
OneEng is a way of reorganizing education to meet the 21st century demands of what it means to be an engineer today.
The really exciting moments begin when students start to ask, what is my ideal undergraduate program that I want to build around my interests? And part of our role as faculty members is helping students to discover and develop their own dreams and visions for what they would like to work on.
To me, I feel like I'm on the forefront to what, you know, new education in America will look like in the future.
OneEng allows you to choose a topic that you're passionate about and choose a topic that is really relevant and applicable to these real-world problems.
So TREX stands for a Traveling Research Environmental Experience. And the purpose of it is to give students experience in field work in environmental science and engineering. We take a group of undergraduates out to do real field work. I find it really exciting to have TREX as part of the OneEng curriculum because field work really is so central to what we as environmental scientists and environmental engineers actually do.
One thing that I really like about the department, it is small, which means that you get a lot of contact with the professors. Being able to kind of have that kind of community is amazing.
You're surrounded by professors and students who are just doing amazing work that is already having such a large impact on the global scale. So when I'm sitting in lecture and a professor is lecturing me, I am aware of the research they're doing, the conferences they're speaking at, and sort of the technologies and the projects that they're working on now that's having such an impact.
It's all about what you want from your life and what you want to achieve. You have the ability to actually make a profound impact because you are poised to be a leader in your field. So who are you not to make a difference in the world?
When I teach classes, I have, you know, on the order of 10 students, but which is great. You know, I know everyone by name. You get to know them over the semester. You can actually have a conversation in class about the topics that you're teaching, and that's a really engaging way to be a teacher and also for people to be learning from us.
What's exciting is the definition of what is a civil engineer is basically up to you as a student. So you can say, for me, it's about public health and air quality, and at MIT, I'm going to become an expert in that by the time I graduate.
I think people would be surprised how much creativity and innovation is going on in Course 1 as far as it pertains to creating new companies and new ventures.
Being a civil engineering student, like the sort of exposure and like academic training that we get, like really like all doors are open. So like whenever you sort of like apply to a job, like you really felt confident that what you're learning and all the skills that you're trained to have within civil engineering really gives you so many like possibilities.
I think with civil environmental engineering, we attract students that want to save the world.
The impact an individual student can have in innovating in this field is enormous. And that is one of the exciting opportunities in big engineering. We can have a significant impact greater than almost any other field in the world.
We live in a thirsty world. Sometimes we have too little, sometimes too much. Here, in Course 1 at MIT, our research group tries to understand the connections between people and nature. When and where are the resources right for agriculture? To make food, the main ingredients are land and water. However, these are not always in the right place at the right time. We collect data on the water cycle and land use. When the data does not make sense, we use physical laws of land and water balances to better approximate reality. With this understanding, we can explore the limits of the system. How can we better provide reliable hydropower when flows are uncertain? To make hydroenergy, the main ingredients are potential head and flowing water. However, the river flows are random. We optimize the reservoir performance over different future scenarios. The objective is to achieve reliable power production by releasing flow, not too much that it would flood and not too little that it would trickle. How can multiple users share water sustainably? The challenge of sustainability is to leave this planet better than we received it. This requires planning. Using game theory, we represent parties reacting to each other's decisions, to economic changes, and to environmental uncertainty. The goal is to develop management strategies that are more realistic and resilient.
As a small part of the larger One at MIT, we are passionate about understanding people's connection with resources.
In our research, we imagine different worlds with the hopes of finding new ways to make our world better, less thirsty,
and more sustainable.
Throughout course one, we felt like there was a disconnect between the research happening in the labs and what we were learning as undergraduates. And only through research did we find out what exactly course one meant. So we thought it was really important to introduce freshmen to course one research before they decided what major to be. It's kind of a crash course Europe, focused on developing or looking in depth into one project like a regular Europe, but the difference is that we also pair the research with social events every week where the freshmen get to learn about each other's Europes and the different research also happening in course one.
I guess what we're ultimately trying to do is to model the flow of a certain chemical called PCB through the Duwamish River in Seattle. And there's a lot of steps to that, starting from the sampling phase, which is kind of taken care of by someone else. But then what we're mostly doing is working with a computer model, kind of in order to understand everything that's going on with that river.
So we're working on a video that is in the style of, it's called MIT Blossoms. And they're educational videos that have short segments and activities for the teacher and the students in between. And this video will be about sediment transport and why it's important.
I definitely think having a hands-on component makes theory more accessible. It makes you feel like what you're studying through papers actually matters.
It's been a really good opportunity to meet other freshmen who are interested in course one. Just a really nice way to have a short introduction to something and then potentially go into it more in spring semester and see if that's really what they want to do.
To me, course one means teamwork, doing something meaningful, and doing something tangible. The undergraduate course Trex wins at that.
Welcome to Traveling Research Environmental Experience. There's a massive volcanic vent on Hawaii'i that burps up to 2,000 tons of SO2 per day, and exposure to that leads to health effects. Trex 2015 wanted to study aspects of the SO2 plume. How can we measure it portably, and what are its effects on soil? We were doing field work. We're talking doing science in a backyard, as well as hours of troubleshooting hardware issues and designing code to make our data pretty. We need each other for that. There were 30 students and staff. Ah, that's a lot. We lived in two different houses. We had a sensor team, soils team, and lab equipment team. We had two different presentation teams. And honestly, a lot of the impact of our research was on us. The large team aspect made us better students. The chaos of fieldwork made us better scientists. How real and local our problem was constantly challenged us to think about our impact and our role as students and scientists. So what are the impacts of our work? For science, one thing is we're designing and testing new ways to sense personal chemical exposure. That's a big deal. But we also engage the public by presenting our work at a local school. Community engagement leaves a huge impact. Residents love telling their stories on experiencing the volcanic smog, and they have tons of questions about the implications of this vent. They really appreciated our presence and the information we had to share, even if we're just scratching the surface and doing a pilot project. Our impact is large, but has only just begun. It's a very large and strange kind of family in our department, but if Ohana means family, Ohana means course one.
What defines research in course one at MIT? My definition stems from the story of my own scientific endeavor. I'm a biologist. I love thinking about genes and proteins and the important roles they play in the lives of cells. When I met my advisor, Roman, he got me thinking about fluents, how differently they appear when we zoom into the microscale. And just like that, my understanding of bacterial lives completely changed. Bacteria grow, and they're really good at it. But they don't just grow, they grow in an incredible and unpredictable world. How do they do it, and does it amount to anything? These questions were swirling around my head until my lab mates, peers, and colleagues taught me about their work, of ecology and biogeochemical cycling, of chemistry, of the ocean, atmosphere, and soil. It really sunk in then just how interconnected all of Earth's systems are, and I realized that I was touching all of it, all by looking into a tiny little flowchip at bacteria growing in changing environments. How do bacteria grow in changing environments? When first faced with this question, I found it absolutely beautiful. And with the support and inspiration of those around me, I watched it grow into something grander, more impactful, and more creative than I could have previously imagined. To me, one at MIT is a style of research, an approach to science and global issues. Sure, some days are better than others. But really, it is a dream come true to every day explore the world with such a warm and diverse community, together as one. Also, just to throw it in there, microbes are awesome.